Come in, pilgrim, lay your burden down. We are all comrades as we travel on the way. We share a common gift, our covenant in Christ, and we are going to celebrate His love today. We will sing and celebrate His love today. When we come to join in prayer, let us first confess we have looked too much to ourselves and loved each other less. Come in, pilgrim, lay your burden down. We are all comrades as we travel on the way. We share a common gift, our covenant in Christ, and we are going to celebrate His love today. We will sing and celebrate His love today.
This Mass is offered for the following intentions. For holy guardian angels and blessings, thanksgiving to Sacred Heart, Mother Mary, Padre Pio and Saint Anthony, wedding anniversary blessings for Andrea and Diego Sequeira, birthday blessings and thanksgiving for Katie in China, Hilda Dantas, Zena Coelho, Yvette DiMello, Sharon Mehta, Leiden Martis, Thomas Mesquita, Sharon, Nora Alex D'Souza, Julio, Sunit Naik, Haley Akyar, Michael D'Souza, Sensia Naidu, Crispin Lawrence and family, good health and happiness for Shelston, Akyar and family, thanksgiving for successful fracture surgery and complete healing and mobility, for the well-being of Bernadette and Edwin D'Souza, birthday remembrance of Bernard Mesquita, Michael Fernandez, Ronald Michael De Rosario, Philip Baptista, for the souls of deceased members of the Montero family, Teresa Cardoza, Sunny, Austin and Victor Craig, Joyce and Jovino D'Souza, Jenny Nazareth, Mervyn Menezes, Arnold Pereira, Flavia, Pereira and Sequeira family, Anju Vaz, Trevor, Tessie, Edward and Brian Fernandez, Donald Colasso, for the deceased members of Colasso and Fernandez families, Irenio Graciano Lewis, Joe and Violet DiMello, Daniel and Margaret Baptista, John Peter Lobo, Rosie D'Souza, Feroz Kambata and family, souls in purgatory, Cajetan DiMello and family. We also pray for all those celebrating birthdays, anniversaries, and all your important intentions. All together. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the priceless communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, on the feast day of the guardian angels, we thank God for His unconditional love in protecting us, guiding us, watching over us through the guardian angels. To celebrate the sacred mysteries of this Eucharist in a worthy manner, let us God remind our sins and ask the Lord's pardon and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
O God, who in your unfathomable providence are pleased to send your holy angels to guard us, hear our supplication as we cry to you, that we may always be defended by their protection and rejoice eternally in their company. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. Thus says the Lord, behold, I send an angel before you to guard you on the way and to bring you to the place that I have prepared. Pay careful attention to him and obey his voice. Do not rebel against him, for he will not pardon your transgression, for my name is in him. But if you carefully obey his voice and do all that I say, then I will be an enemy to your enemies and an adversary to your adversaries. When my angel goes before you and brings you to the Amorites and the Hittites and the Perizzites and the Canaanites, the Hivites and the Jebusites, and I blot them out. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response is, for you has he commanded his angels to keep you in all your ways. Kindly listen to the tune.
For you has he commanded his angels to keep you in all your ways. All together. For you has he commanded his angels to keep you in all your ways.
He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High and abides in the shade of the Almighty says to the Lord, my refuge, my stronghold, my God in whom I trust. Together.
For you has he commanded his angels to keep you in all your ways.
He will free you from the snare of the fowler, from the destructive plague. He will conceal you with his pinions, and under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness is buckler and shield. Together.
For you has he commanded his angels to keep you in all your ways. Alleluia. Alleluia. All together. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Bless the Lord, all his hosts, his servants, who do his will.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, the disciples came to Jesus saying, who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven? And calling to him a child, he put him in the midst of them and said, truly, I say to you, unless you turn and become like children, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. Whoever humbles himself like this child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. Whoever receives one such child in my name, receives me. See that you do not despise one of these little ones. For I tell you that in heaven their angels always see the face of my Father who is in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Catechism of the Catholic Church, CCC, number 336 tells us, beside each believer stands an angel as protector and shepherd, leading him or her to life. Angels are messengers, God's servants. What is the function of these angels? Angels are called to pray and to worship God. They're called to watch over us. They're called to protect us. My dear friends, at this Eucharist, we are reminded that we ought to be angels to one another. And the greatest angel protecting us is God, Jesus Himself. At this Eucharist, let us pray that we may never shun our responsibility in guarding those who are below us, in guarding and protecting those who are under our care. Today on 2nd October, our country, our nation, India celebrates Gandhi Jayanti. We thank God for the gift of Mahatma Gandhi, a wonderful guardian to our nation. He always stood for peace, non-violence. So let us pray this Eucharist that in our country there is peace, all over the world there is peace, and we ourselves may become like Him, peacemakers at all times. Amen.
In bread we bring you, Lord, our body's labor. In wine we offer you our spirit's grief. We do not ask you, Lord, who is my neighbor, but stand united now, one in belief, for we have gladly heard your word, your holy word, and now in answer, Lord, our gifts we bring, our selfish hearts make true, our failing faith renew. Our lives belong to you, our Lord and King.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and good of all His holy Church.
Receive, O Lord, the offerings we bring before you as we venerate your holy angels, and graciously grant that under their constant protection we may be delivered from present dangers and brought happily to life eternal, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise you without end in your archangels and angels. For the honor we pay the angelic creatures in whom you delight redounds to your own surpassing glory, and by their great dignity and splendor you show how infinitely great you are, to be exalted above all things through Christ our Lord. Through him the multitude of angels extols your majesty, and we are united with them in exultant adoration, as with one voice of praise we acclaim:
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the new fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Oswald Gracious, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you, through your Son, Jesus Christ.
O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever.
Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
We make an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus,
I believe
that you are present in the most holy sacrament.
I love you
above all things,
and I desire
to receive you
into my soul.
Since I cannot at this moment
receive you sacramentally,
come at least spiritually
into my heart.
I embrace you
as if you were already there
and unite myself
wholly to you.
Never permit me
to be separated from you.
Amen.
O Lord, I am not worthy, yet you come to live in me. So speak your word of comfort, by your touch strengthen and heal me. Onward through life we journey, as seekers of the truth, building each day a new world of justice, peace and love. O Lord, I am not worthy, yet you come to live in me. So speak your word of comfort, by your touch strengthen and heal me.
We make our prayer for guardian angel. Angel of God, my guardian dear, to whom God's love comes to hear, ever this day be at my side, to light and guard, to rule and guide.
Amen.
As you are pleased to nourish us for eternal life, with so great a sacrament, O Lord, direct us by the ministry of angels into the way of salvation and peace, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Our Lady of Mount,
pray for us. May the angels go with you to the home of God's glory. May the saints bid you welcome to the land of the living. Praise the Lord, all you nations. Praise the Lord, all you people. We have witnessed his mercy. He is faithful forever.